One of the most powerful vehicles in the stock market is trading options. Most people complicate it, but today I'm going to simplify it for you all. I'm going to be giving you a singular setup that in this given market will straight up make you money, period. Before we get into the charts, let's quickly talk about what type of options we will be trading with this. We'll be trading weekly options contracts that are in the money. We don't care about the Greeks as day traders. Remember, we are day traders, and day traders do not care about the Greeks, as long as you follow this to the T. This setup will also only work with the SPY and the Qs, but preferably the SPY. This is just the very tip of the iceberg when it comes to the Trick Trades Boss option strategy. And if you'd like more information, head to tricktrades.com. The reason this will work, will, capital W-I-L-L, is because, not just because of technical reasons, but everything to do with psychology and human nature. So now pay attention, grab a pen and paper, and take notes, and don't be afraid to watch this multiple times. And remember, ask gas or grass, ain't nobody ride for free, folks. So make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. With that said, let's now get into the charts, and let's make you some money. Let's roll. Okay, so we have the SPY here, and what we're looking for, this is an end of day setup. This is an end of day setup. I'm not saying that this is the best setup ever to take. This just is the best setup for end of day day trading options when we're trading the SPY. Now, this has everything to do, like I mentioned before, about human nature. And the reason why it has to do with human nature is if something doesn't happen, the market will react a certain way. It's just how it is. That's how the world works, okay? So if you look at it from that perspective, you'll do well and you'll understand what I'm saying. So end of day, especially when the market, now remember, this has everything to do with the market being at all-time highs. This setup will also work. I don't care if you're watching this a year from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, it'll continue to work. But the one catch is it needs to be at all-time highs or at a low, like a dip, a big dip, not just a little pullback, but a big extreme dip. And this will work. So with that said, let's kind of start dissecting this chart as to why it's squeezed up. Now, some people will say this is hindsight, and it's not. This is a setup that we take all the time in this given market at Trick Trades. At the end of the day, if it is consolidating, you can see here, the market was just consolidating. It broke down and then quickly got bought up. And when it got bought up, you can see shorts were covering. It's getting towards the end of the day, going into a long weekend, folks. Okay, so I'm gonna mark out a level. You can see here, this is roughly the base. This is the lows that it was having problems with breaking. And once it broke, it quickly remounted and shot back up. As it approaches 3 p.m., it's the fight or flight mode. It has to pick a direction. In a market like this, when shorts are jumping in, it's not going to just consolidate into the close or just chop into the close. It won't do that. Especially coming into a long weekend, we're going to either sell off really hard for the last 40, 45 minutes, or it will squeeze out, which is what it did. The reason why it squeezed out is because it couldn't break down. Now, I'm gonna say that again. I know that sounds really simple, guys, but just pay attention and just listen to this. If the market can't sell off, if it cannot break that level on that last test, just after 3 p.m., it will, capital W-I-L-L, it will squeeze. It has no choice but to squeeze. So how do we trade it? How do we execute that? Well, knowing what we know about human nature and psychology, shorts will get squeezed if that doesn't break down, because we're heading into a long weekend and just a weekend in general, or even the end of day, nobody wants to hold shorts overnight. What shorts are doing, they're piling in each intraday session looking to pick the top. That's what's going on. That's why you keep seeing big squeezes up or a big sell-off into the close. It's the same idea, and it has everything to do with with the market being up at all-time highs, and people don't know what the hell is going to go on. They don't know whether the market's going to gap up or gap down, but people are trying to pick tops, especially shorts are trying to pick tops, right? They keep getting fucked because it's not breaking down. They, as in them, the powers that be, are holding this market up right now. There's a lot of stuff going on in the background of the market, and it's important to realize that. Just because we're at all-time highs and we're extended on a bull run, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. Okay, this market can very easily keep going. Now, I'm not saying it's going to. If I had to pick a side, I would say that, yes, the market's going to pull back. When it happens, it happens. Okay, but that's what people are trying to pick. They're trying to pick tops. Shorts are trying to pick tops right now. If it doesn't break down at the end of the day, they will not hold overnight. Let's get into how we would execute this, folks. We're given a clue. We're given a clue that this sold off, it broke that level, but quickly got bought back up. So that should tell you the odds of this breaking again and actually selling off are probably gonna be pretty low, because as soon as it breaks, shorts are gonna start taking some covers, because we are getting into the close and they're not gonna wanna sell, or sorry, they're not gonna wanna hold over the weekend, because we didn't get a big enough sell off on Friday. Like, it didn't sell off enough. Like, if we came down and we maybe broke this level intraday, like down over here, then yes, they would most likely hold. You gotta remember, don't think of this as from the perspective of your small account. Your small account is not how the majority of the big money is. Big money is big money. They've got a lot of money on the line, and because they have a lot of money on the line, they want these stocks or the market to prove itself. They want it to prove itself before actually risking stuff. These guys are not gamblers, folks. That's the thing, and that's why trading the market, stuff like the SPY or proper stocks like stocks like Apple or Nvidia or Facebook, it follows the rules, because they have to. They have rules in place because they're trading with such a large amount of capital. With it not breaking down, this squeezed right back up. But like I said, well, this is simply putting the pieces together. Now, this is where it's going to get interesting. Let me repeat this. Because it broke this level and quickly got bought back up and squeezed back up, you have a nice subtle piece of the puzzle that, even if this breaks down, it's probably going to squeeze back up, because again, it didn't break any major key support levels intraday, so it's still perceived as strong. So as it comes into this level, this main intraday base level, okay, from 1 p.m. on, it's tested multiple times, three times. As it comes into that level, execute. Buy calls, buy them, risk off of low of day, okay? Now that's what you can do. And the beautiful thing on this is you literally had, let's see here. So from lows, back to your entry or rough entry, you have 30 cents, well within your tolerance. Now some of you are probably looking at this and saying, well, it didn't touch that level, so you can't, how do you execute that? It didn't touch it. You would have missed it. No, that's not how you trade, folks. You need to take it as you start in, as it's coming into that level. Now, as it comes into a level of acceptable risk, you initiate your trade. You don't need to go in full size, okay? Full size when it hits the level. But as it comes into that level, you can simply start in. So even if you only, let's say you started in really small with one or two contracts, this would have been, especially it being a Friday, 100% move, if not more, okay? So you'd buy in the money options. Now the squeeze is gonna get really interesting, especially if it breaks this. Now remember, on SPY options, you have 15 minutes after the market closes in order to get rid of your contracts. So you're all right. So that's exactly how I would trade this. Now guys, like I said at the beginning of this, rewatch this, okay? I know it seems like very simple information, but there is a ton of information here if you're really paying attention. This stuff is pure gold, and I really want to help you guys, so that's why I'm trying to put out the best free content that I can without taking away from my members as well, With that said, we're going to do a live Q&A after this, so make sure to have some questions ready. And if you want to become a real trader trading real stocks, come to TrickTrades.com and check out the SPY Sniper option strategy as well as the Boss option strategy available at TrickTrades.com. So on that note, folks, have a good one. Talk to you later. Adios.